ॐ भूर्भुवः स्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। नमस्ते माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू ए वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वीडियो अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ द विवेकानंदा रॉक मेमोरियल एट कन्याकुमारी इन तमिलनाडु। आई शैल एक्सप्लेन टू यू द मोटिव बिहाइंड द होल प्रोजेक्ट। विवेकानंदा केंद्रा इज टू बी कॉल्ड VK। टू बिगिन द स्टोरी वी विल हैव टू गो बैक टू 1962। स्वामी विवेकानंदा वॉज बोर्न इन जनवरी 1863। द एंटायर पीरियड फ्रॉम द 100th टू द 101st बर्थडे ऑफ स्वामी जी एज प्रपोज टू बी सेलिब्रेटेड एज द सेंटेनरी ईयर द रामकृष्णा मिशन प्लांट इट ऑन एन ऑल इंडिया स्केल। During the whole year, there were discourses and speeches about the life teachings of Swami Vivekananda. Till then, Swamiji's works were published in English and Hindi. Now, the publications were taken up in all languages because the government gave a very good subsidy. Beginnings in January 1962, the people of Kanyakumari thought that as Swamiji's birth centenary was being celebrated, it would be in the fitness of things if they put up some memorial on the rock where he meditated and discovered the mission of his life. It occurred naturally to everybody there must be access to the place, especially as it was known as Sri Pada Praya, where goddess Kanyakumari meditated, did her sadhana to obtain the hand of Lord Shiva so that they also could go and sit at the sacred spot. Some people in Kanyakumari came together. Sri Velayudhan Pillai, president of Handeva Shiva Sangh, took the lead and with others thought of forming a committee for the purpose. They thought, let us have a memorial and also put a pedestrian bridge so that people can commute across. At the time, they could not define what type of memorial should be made. Almost simultaneously, there was a public meeting at Madras with a lead by the Ramakrishna Mission. They thought on the same lines, some divergent forces. When these two groups got together, news spread that some memorial on the Vivekananda Rock was being contemplated. A section of the Catholics at Kanyakumari did not take kindly to the contemplated scheme and thought something should be done to thwart it. You may be knowing that Kanyakumari has a sizable population of Christian fishermen. They were Hindus earlier, 400 years ago, but they claim that Saint Xavier converted their ancestors when he went there. In this situation, a section of the Catholics put up on the rock a big cross which was visible from the shore. It has its natural repercussions. The people immediately convened protest meetings and sent a telegram to the collector, chief minister, president and prime minister that this rock where the Sri Padam is imprinted is a place of worship for Hindus and putting up a cross was a trespass. At the time, the Kanyakumari temple Devaswam claimed that the rock was its property because of the Sri Padam impressed on it. Perhaps long ago, the rock was a part of the mainland. If goddess Kanyakumari did her sadhana on the rock, there must have been a connection between the temple and the rock. On the basis of this legend, the Devaswam stopped its claim. The first thing that Kanyakumari District Committee referred to about it was to apply on 19th August 1962 to the Devas Worm Board for permission to put up a memorial on the rock and to have a pedestrian bridge joining the mainland to the rock. It also sought permission to put up a memorial on the rock and to have a pedestrian bridge joining the mainland to the rock. It also sought permission to start a free boat service till a bridge was constructed. That time there was no ferry service as compared to today. The board felt that people might like to go to the rock to see the place where Swamiji meditated, where Kanyakumari did her meditation and sadhana. So the board immediately permitted the committee to run a free service, put up a memorial, and also to have a bridge and everything else provided on completion. These were handed over to them. The committee also agreed to do so. Taking advantage of the permission, the committee wanted first to start a ferry service, but from where was it to get the boatman? The people in the surrounding areas were all Christians and they would never cooperate. So the committee members went to Kerala to Calicut and persuaded 10 to 15 and 20 people on the premise that they would not only have to run the boats but fight with the locals too. The people were now able to go daily to rock except when the sea was rough. People's emotions were stirred when they saw the cross of recent origin. Meanwhile, the Madras government ordered a judicial probe and declared that the cross be removed. It also declared in unequivocal terms that this was Vivekananda Rock. The revenue department was ordered to remove the cross. A section of the Christians in Kerala raised a chorus that a cross was there for the last 400 years and it was removed by some Hindus. Here, I must tell you one significant fact. Kanyakumari district was a part of Travancore state because it has a predominance of Tamil-speaking people. Following the state reorganization on linguistic basis, it became part of Tamil Nadu. One fine morning, people noticed there was no cross on the rock. Now Hindus and Christians assembled there were virtually arrayed against each other as if in a battle formation. The police reached there, promulgated section 144, declared that the rock was a prohibited area and posted on armed guard on the rock. Eager to avoid a confrontation, the state government asked the Devas Worm board to write to the committee that though it had taken permission from the board, it must get concurrence of the state government also. The committee sought the state government's approval, but it was refused. If the committee wanted to have a memorial, it could be on the shore but not on the rock. 3 or 4 months elapsed in this process, and January 1963, the 100th birthday of Swamiji was approaching. People were eager that something must be done by January 1963. Sri Bhaktavatsalam, chief minister, said, "I will not allow the memorial. It is also true that this is a Vivekananda rock and seal must be put there that is Vivekananda rock so that there must be no confusion in the minds of the people and no controversy comes up later that it is St. Xavier's this or that. I suggest that there should be only a tablet on which will be written that Swami Vivekananda visited this rock on such and such date, meditated here and all that." Since matters had taken a different turn, committee members felt the need to have an All India Committee. Several prominent people were approached. They agreed that the committee was registered in March 1963. So when Sri Bhaktavatsalam insisted that there should be only a tablet put on the rock, the district committee people thought, let us accept this for the time being. Let us establish a claim on the rock. Let the tablet be established there. We shall continue to negotiate with the government for the memorial, but let us accept this. Accordingly, a tablet was installed on the rock on January 17, 1963, but people felt that there should be a statue. They had their own plans for the memorial. In February 1963, the general body of the All India Committee met at Madras. In that body were Swami Chinmayananda, Guruji Golwalkar, Sri Mannath Padmanabhan, amongst others. After the committee meeting, there was a public meeting, and all in one voice demanded that there should be a full-fledged memorial on the rock. In that meeting, Swami Chinmayananda made the first donation of ₹10,000 from Chinmaya Mission. By and by, a number of important persons came to be closely connected with our work. In the meantime, a wreck vengeance on us for the removal of the cross from the rock. Some of the Catholics on May 16, 1963, demolished the tablet and threw it on the sea. How Eknath ji came into the picture. It was in August 1963 that I came into the picture. I was General Secretary of the RSS, and in that capacity was going round the country, and that time I had gone to Kanyakumari too. In 1962, I laid down my office as General Secretary of the RSS. Since my appointment was a stopgap arrangement, there were celebrations all over the country on account of Swamiji's birth centenary. Some people thought that there should be a small book on Swamiji. Since I was free at that time, people also thought that I should take up the work. I also liked the idea. Went at Calcutta and compiled a book to be released on Swamiji's 100th birthday in January 1963. I presented the book to Sri Madhavananda Maharaj, the president of the Ramakrishna Mission. Madhavananda Maharaj, the president of the Ramakrishna Mission. The book was titled as A Rousing Call to Hindu Nation. The book was quite popular and was translated in almost all the languages. So when this whole thing became hot and committee people knew that the Madras government would not budge an inch and would not allow a memorial on the rock, they were in a fix as to what to do. They thought of an agitation, but the atmosphere was not congenial for a memorial at Kanyakumari for a Swami Vivekananda from Bengal. So the committee were in a fix. At the time I was in Nagpur. After our meeting in July, I was going to leave Nagpur for a tour. At the time, some important people of the committee approached Guruji Golwalkar and said, now that Sri Rana Dey is free, why not ask him to help? He was some effective contacts in Delhi and Calcutta. He has contacts. Let him meet the persons who met in Delhi and let them influence Sri Bhaktavatsalam. Let them influence Sri Kamaraj to give us permission for putting up the memorial on the rock. Since I had already compiled a book on the teachings of Swami Vivekananda, they thought I was in tune with the work. They talked to Guruji, who asked me casually, these people are saying that your services could be useful, so what do you think about it? I also casually said, I will have to study the whole problem. I must know and study the whole thing, and if you think that I can be of any use, I will go there, study the situation, and then I will be able to tell you whether I will be of any use. So I agreed to go to Kanyakumari and Madras at the earliest, study the papers, and then give my final word. But I thought, first let me sound the Ramakrishna Mission and know what it has to say about it. So I went to Calcutta, met the respected Madhavananda Maharaj on July 22, 1963, when I was in Calcutta from 1952 1953, I was a regular visitor to Bellur Math and used to meet Swamiji there every fortnight. I told him that some people proposed to do something about the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, but first of all the President Maharaj should tell me whether he was interested in this. Swami said something very significant. As a matter of fact, the mission should have taken up this work, but we know the mind of the central government, we know the mind of the Tamil Nadu government, and we know how they react in such situation. Now that some Christians have put up an opposition, the Tamil Nadu government will never agree, and so will the central government. So what is the use? If we sannyasin put a word, we know what is going to be the fate. We, an organization of the sannyasins, cannot agitate and cannot mobilize public opinion. Thus we cannot come into the picture. But if a person like you is prepared to take up the work, and if the whole committee is behind you, I assure you that though the Ramakrishna Mish will not be in any way officially connected with you, you can be rest assured the entire mission will be at your back at that time. So finally, there were some good people in the central government who were favorable to the idea of a rock material in Kanyakumari. But equally, there were people who were opposing this idea. And our great Nehruji was never in favor of any monument to be erected for Hindus. He was a Hindu for just namesake, but in reality, he was God knows what he was. He was always favoring the minorities, and Hindus were nothing for him, because his main aim was to install Indira Gandhi and further Nehru and Gandhi generations to be Prime Minister of India and all. So finally, due to interference of some divine forces, this memorial came into being, and now it is very much there. It is very, very holy place. I have visited this place around 2000, somewhere, not 2000, around 1992 or 91. And really, there is a, place at the bottom of the rock for meditation. What a wonderful experience it was. So every Hindu must go there and donate some money to the mission there. So it is a very good thing. Thank you for watching this video, my dear friends. Thank you so much. Thank you. Please share, comment, and like the video, and please subscribe my channel so that I will be able to give you very, very important and best videos. Thank you.